So, in this video, I'd like to discuss my testimony. I was saved and made a profession of faith at about age 7. So many years ago, I was taken to church and I heard the preacher speaking. His name was Sam Bryant, Brother Sam. He was a great preacher that meant a lot to me, still does. And he was a very passionate, loud-voiced preacher, and he taught the word. And he taught fire and brimstone. I mean, he was a very good preacher. I learned a lot. I enjoyed his sermons. And so I heard him talking about hell, heaven and hell, and the choice that we all have to make. And so naturally, I decided to make that choice. So I spoke to my father and I told him I wanted to make that choice. And so I received some counseling. They questioned me and they felt like I had a good grasp on what was going on. So they went ahead and let me make a public profession of faith, which is the custom in that church, was to go down front and make a public profession of faith, which I did that. Then shortly after that, I was baptized. So by the time I was 8, I was saved and baptized. And then continued on the path of righteousness through school, through high school, all the way through college, and so on. And later, much later, I began to go through a few peaks and valleys. Some situations where I wasn't questioning God. I never questioned God. I never questioned his existence or his sufficiency. The only things I would question would be my salvation. So I began to question my salvation. My father worked in Christian radio for many years. He was a Christian DJ. He worked in a radio station where they had a lot of religious programs on, so I was exposed to a lot of teaching. And unfortunately, at the time, I didn't understand this at all, but now I do. It was Calvinistic in nature. It was Reformed theology. Who wasn't Calvinist was Arminian. So I was exposed to a lot of those types of teachings. And yet deep down inside, I still knew somehow. I studied the Bible, and so I was pretty well grounded on the fact that once saved, always saved. That was my belief. I used to say, if saved, always saved. But anyway, I knew that to be true, thanks to the Bible and studying. And there was like this disconnect between what I was hearing the preacher say and what I knew to be true. I heard a lot of preachers saying that you were once saved, always saved. But I heard a lot of lordship salvation teaching, a lot of repent of your sins teaching. Those things were prevalent. And so I began to doubt my salvation quite a bit. And I'd say probably about, give it 5 years. Say probably 5 years ago, I was really in a dark place spiritually. Again, I want to stress this. I never doubted the existence of God. Never. Never doubted the existence of God or the possibility of salvation or the sufficiency of the blood of Christ or any of that. I never doubted that. What I doubted was my standing with regard to that. In other words, I began to doubt my own salvation. So that's when I entered a few dark places in my mind where people I know, people I love, they started to die, and I started to think possibly they had gone to hell because I saw them deal with things. I saw them deal with addictions. I saw them deal with weakness. They dealt with the flesh. And they dealt with things that they could not overcome. Because of the certain teachings I was listening to, I began to think perhaps they were never saved because their lives were not perfect and sinless, or even somewhat sinless in some cases. And so I began to doubt their salvation. So I was entering some dark areas spiritually, as I said. Now we come to the good part. The good part. I stumbled across a video by a man named Greg Jackson. I mention his name because the man made a difference in my life. Greg Jackson posts videos all the time. And he drum beats this. You're saved by grace through faith, and that not of yourselves. Ephesians 2, 8 and 9. This became my new favorite scripture. Of course, my favorite scripture, as many are, many people's favorite scripture, is John 3, 16. Well, that's one of my favorites. But in addition to that one is Ephesians 2, 8 and 9. So these two scripture passages are the ones that form the main core of my spiritual beliefs. John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever should believe in him should not perish but have everlasting life. And Ephesians 2:8-9. For by grace are we saved through faith, and that not of yourselves. Is a gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast. Those are my two favorite passages because I feel like those two passages together tell the complete story of what we need to do, what Christ did, what we need to do. The condition is we believe. We believe, we trust, and he does all the work. At that point, you're saved forever. So this was a very big moment for me when I realized that there is a thing out there. There is a thing, a form of belief that adheres closely to the Bible, strictly to the Word. It doesn't deviate from the Word. It doesn't pull things out of context. It doesn't take random and make random connections. It flows perfectly in line with the doctrines of the Bible. It doesn't adhere and rely on man-made doctrines, only on those doctrines which come directly out of the Bible. Nothing that we believe is based on anything interpretive or reading between the lines or anything like that. No inferences, nothing. It's all directly pulled from Scripture, and that's free grace. And when I found free grace theology, I realized that I had found biblical truth finally. And so it was a huge moment, and I'm just overjoyed that now I can move forward and live with the assurance that I'm saved forever and that there's no condemnation now. It's beyond words how wonderful that feels. I thank Jesus every day. I pray more. There's a more hopeful feeling in my heart. The feelings have come. So it's an awesome feeling to know 100% that you're saved, and it's through Jesus, not through yourself. He gets all the credit. He did all the work. Jesus died on the cross, not me. I bought into it by trusting him. He joined me in, and it's a great feeling. So I just wanted to get on here and sort of tell you about my journey to this point. And then I started this YouTube channel where I decided to start defending the faith and trying to help others get away from Calvinism, get away from Arminianism, get away from the cults, get away from charismatic insanity, get away from ecumenicism and all of those things that are tearing down humanity, and try to bring it to the truth, which is free grace theology, which is saved by grace through faith in Christ alone, plus nothing. That's it. You're saved by Christ alone and by God's work, not our own. You're not saved by works, not at all. That's me, and that's who I am, Mike from Easy Salvation, and I thank you for watching this video. And if you feel so inclined, please, please go ahead and hit the subscribe button, and just, you know, help a brother out. I'm trying to just spread the word, and if more people can hear the truth and understand what's going on, then it's a wonderful thing. So thank you for watching this. So with that, I'm going to bid you farewell, and thank you for watching my video. God bless.